After 25 days of DHL transit that should have taken 5 to 7 days, the nexdock touch is here. This is a short unboxing feature video. In the box is the device, a bunch of adapters, including a power brick and cord that's I've already plugged in, a couple other adapters of different types, including HDMI, which I'll get to. And other than that, it's ready to go. So how does it work? I've got a USB-C cable hooked up to my Note 20, and I'm going to plug it in. That was easy. And then press and hold the power button. Nexdock's ready to connect. Phone claims to be charging. And Dex comes up really quickly. I've plugged in a Logitech USB adapter to get an external mouse, but we've got the trackpad and the touchscreen. All that can drive the CPU. So let's see how the sound works. Okay, so the sound is coming out of my phone. To change that, I'm going to click on the speaker, change audio output, and select display device. Now I'm getting it from the nexdock. It's a little, it's not bad. It's probably a good laptop sound quality. Not great and not poor. It's probably good. So that's that. That's easy enough. Right away, I'm working in Dex, no problem. Open up an editor. Keyboard feels like a laptop keyboard. Trackpad fails. Maybe a little soft in the trackpad, but everything works as you'd expect, and certainly as good as Dex would be anyplace else. So we're really just driving the screen now with a little help from a keyboard and a trackpad. So those are the basic functionality. I'm still able to use my phone separately if I wanted to make a call. With this stiff cable, it's really hard to maneuver, and you can see strain on the connecting ports, which I'm not thrilled about. I'll probably find a more flexible C to C USB cable. Bonus feature is I have this Amazon Fire TV stick. I'm going to plug that in, and boom, I'm now watching my Amazon Fire on the nexdock. That's kind of cool. Of course, none of the controls work. I'm using the control for the Fire, but that's kind of nice that it's got an HDMI input. So that's the end of my quick feature video. Just one other thing I'll highlight is Wonderground really does look good on Dex. It's my favorite weather program for Dex, including this extended forecast that gives probability of precipitation along with temperature on a daily basis with the ability to drill into details. So that's it for now. I hope you enjoy your nexdock if you ordered one, or if this helps you consider one.